Yo, Wagwan Internet, Kyle Linux there. So I decided today I'm going to support Feral Interactive for porting yet another great game over to Linux. They have finally answered the prayers and the cries of many Linux gamers by releasing Rise of the Tomb Raider on Linux this morning, April 19th, at I think 10 Pacific time, 10 a.m. PST. PST Pacific Standard Time, Kyle. But yeah, so it's an exciting time right now because I just played about an hour into it. I played this game before on Xbox One several years ago and I loved it, but I needed to get it again because it's on Linux and because I no longer have an Xbox One. So, man, when I say that this game runs amazingly, it does. You guys know my system specs, it's always in the description, but 24 gigs of RAM, i5, 4460, GTX 970. I played the game for an hour on very high, but with blur turned off, motion blurs turned off, and the vignette blur is also turned off. And I did not have any problems, man. The only time that I saw any form of stuttering was during one cutscene. And I mean, it was brief. It was just a few seconds, so it wasn't even that big of a deal. The game, like gameplay-wise, smooth. I never play third-person games with a mouse and keyboard. It's just not something I do. I usually use my controller for that. And the DualShock 4 works great with the game. I played for a little bit with the DualShock 4. And the button prompts are the DualShock 4 button prompts. So thank you, Feral, for making sure that all that stuff is in sync. Give thanks. Give thanks tremendously. But I found myself playing this game with the mouse and the keyboard because I was genuinely curious. I said, you know what? Let me try playing a third-person perspective game with a mouse and keyboard, and it's actually very comfortable, not to mention aiming is extremely simple now. Like, it's kind of broken simple. It, you know, just like when you're playing a first-person shooter with a mouse, it's like shooting fish in a bucket sometimes, right? So that has been my current experience with the game. I ran the benchmark, and you should be seeing the benchmark on the screen right now. As you're looking at the benchmark, you'll see that my average frame rate was about 70-ish frames per second, right? The minimum was at 20 frames per second, I guess, during one part of the benchmark, but you barely noticed. Like, even as I was watching the benchmark playthrough, I saw like one section where it's like, oh, this minor frame skip here, and then that was it. Rest is just smooth. So playing the game on high, I turned it down to the high setting. That's actually what I started playing the game in, was on high, not very high. And playing the game on the high setting, smooth as butter. No stuttering, not even during the cutscenes. The game was just running smoothly. I turned it up to very high just because I was curious. The game is still smooth, just not as smooth as it was on high. And by smooth, I mean you're looking at, you know, the 50 to the 60 frames per second and up. For very high, and then for high was about like between probably 60 and 80 was what I was seeing. So very, very, very good job, Feral Interactive. Thank you guys for continuing to support us on Linux. Thank you for continuing to port the games that we're requesting, man. This is a good time. It's a good time. I'm trying to think of what else there is to say. Please bring Nier Automata over if you can. I just beat that on PS4, but I honestly would not mind having that on Linux if it meant that I would be able to do like a, you know, full 100% completion or doing all the side quests and stuff. Because on the PlayStation, I basically just ran through the story because I loved the first Nier and I was curious about the story for this one. So a lot of the lore is hidden in the side quests. So I would definitely play it again on Linux if it ever came out. So yeah, that's really all I would add on there. Feral, if you're listening, please and thank you. And Sonic Mania too, if you can. But outside of that, you guys should definitely go check this out. I supported Feral like at their store. I went and purchased the game in their store for full price. And I know some people might think that's really dumb. Like, why would you pay full price for a game you previously owned and already beaten? And it's to support the company who's supporting us. That's why. And then a couple minutes later, I hopped on Steam and saw that the same game was on sale or is on sale for like $19. So there's a little part of me that was like, man, there's a tiny part of me that was a little upset. But at the same time, I realized that it's for a good cause. It is to support a company that is benefiting a platform that I do believe in and have a lot of faith in. So I feel like it was money well spent. And I had that money stowed away for games too. That's part of my entertainment fund. So it's all good. Anyway, that's all I really wanted to touch on. You know, I'm just rambling right now just so that you guys can see the gameplay footage. Go check this out. Make sure you're on Ubuntu 17.10 or higher. I know 18.04 is about to be released. Make sure you have Vulkan installed. I'll put the command in the description box to get Vulkan installed once you are already on 17.10. I'm not sure if it works on 16.04. I actually just updated from Ubuntu Mate over to Pop OS by System76 because I was genuinely curious about the distro. And I have to say, I'm kind of crushing on this distro right now, man. Like, I definitely feel that this is very smooth and just fits my needs. There's a lot of hate for GNOME 3 for some reason, but I find it interesting because people were complaining about Unity. Then when GNOME 3 got announced, everyone started complaining how much they missed Unity. People just weird. But anyway, yeah, GNOME 3 for me, no problems. Everything's doing what I needed to do. I'm happy. So I'm on Pop OS. 17.10, 18.04 is going to come out. I'm going to give it some time, make sure all the bugs are ironed out for that one, and then I'll switch to the 18.04 branch. But as long as you're on 17.10, get Vulkan installed. Make sure you have the NVIDIA 396 driver installed. Yeah, the NVIDIA 396 driver needs to be installed in order for Vulkan to work correctly, and then you can download and install the game and go ham, man. You should have a good time. They also have a game mode. Feral Interactive came up with this script called game mode that basically allows your games and programs to run with maximum CPU performance. You don't have to use their game mode option. You can just use, I can't remember what the name is. It's the CPU governor, changing the setting on that to high performance, or just performance versus power saving. And I'll put the details to that in the description as well, and you can check that out down there. But I need to stop rambling now because the video is already going on past 8 minutes and I'm sure you guys are tired of hearing this. So this has been Kai Linux, and remember, no matter what distro you use, out of many, one Linux. Give thanks to Feral Interactive and to you for tuning in. Peace.